Change it out with you?
Not great, to be honest. I'm staying on a mate's sofa.
Well, maybe you shouldn't have done the date with Portia's husband.
You remember Derek?
Really? Been a long time.
Will you get that monster out of here?
I'm so proud of you. You're so clever.
Really?
And you smash your exams.
No, let's just see if I can get this essay finished first. He can't walk. He needs medication to even breathe properly.
Mum.
Oh, not now.
Mum, I've lost my essay on this poem. File's just disappeared.
Poem? Is that all you've got to worry about? A poem?
I've got the notes, but they're just at school on a memory stick. It's got to be in first thing.
Oh, well, boo-hoo, Cleo. I wish I had your life, Reenie.
I can't do anything anyway with you lot constantly screaming.
Yeah, well, go on then, clear off to a mate's house, you self-centred little cow.
Keep it down.
Fine, I'm going.
Just for one night, can't we lay off each other? I'll drop you off, Clee.
You need some rest, sweetheart.
Sweetheart. You say one more bad word about him and you're out of here with the police on your case. Because you need locking up. You were going to kill him.
Whoa, pause, stop.
Why should I?
Well, because if you want a divorce, then half of everything is yours, so you're basically just vandalising your own stuff.
Okay.
Well, I do. Okay, come on, come here.
Put me down, Jumbo!
No, I am saving you from a criminal damage charge.
Oh, I will criminally damage you if you don't put me down!
God bless. Father O'Donnell said he'd be pleased to marry us. Oh, so much to organise. And if we get a rush on, we can apply for a licence.
Oh, I'm going to hang on, then, however long it takes.
Oh, Derek.
Nothing matters to me now except your happiness.
Is there anyone you'd like me to invite from your side?
Of course there isn't. Why do you think he's come crawling back here?
Reenie!
He's a sad, pathetic old man, scared witless of going to hell. And you are coming to hell, Derek.
I am at breaking point with you.
I am not letting you marry him.
You can't stand in our way, because you're not invited.
You're choosing him over your own daughter all over again. Do you know, you were the worst mum when I was little. Letting me grow up in a house where he beat you up.
This is all in the past.
I mean, to watch you slap on the concealer the next day, lying to the neighbours about tripping over the dog. You're still the same sad, gullible, stupid woman now.
I put up with everything, because Derek was paying the bills, and I loved him, no matter what.
This is my chance to put things right.
You will never, ever put things right, Derek, and you know that.
What sacrifices did you ever make for your kids, eh? And the way you speak to Portia.
It's because she hates me.
Because you're a cow to her.
Because she's always trying to get in between me and Pete, the only good thing that I've got.
Too good for you.
Mum?
You always tried to come between me and Derek. And you are not doing it now. You gave him such a hard time. You stroppy little teenager. Oh, here she goes.
Oh, Pete. Come home quick. Before I do something I'll regret.
Where did you get the keys from?
I've just landed the job doing building work here.
This is brilliant. What happens if we get caught?
Do you want to make this deadline or what?
Got it. Now can you drop me off at Katie? It's just where we'll be finishing her essay.
Why didn't you do it here?
It's not supposed to be here.
Oh, come on, Cleo. Break the rules. It's an adventure. I'll help you.
I thought you were rubbish at poetry.
Yeah, but if you go to your mate, she'll spend all night gossiping.
True.
And I'll keep you from any distractions. And by the time you're finished, your mum will have passed out. She won't remember what she said in the morning.
Well, I will.
You're stressed out, love. Once you've done this, everything will be so much better.
What would I do without you?
Get to work. I'll go and raid the vending machines for some treats. Keep your energy up. And I won't take no for an answer. Yes.
Do you know what? I expected nothing less from Mercedes. She's never happier than when she's stealing somebody else's man, but you!
Sorry.
All the times you won't behind my back. How sorry were you then? Sorry.
Lockie started it.
No, don't you dare blame Lockie for your lack of self-control, because I am about to swing for your job, Paul. You know, I'm divorcing him, right? I'm going to cut you and him out of my life for good. And from this second, I'm not going to be the stupid woman that he cheats on. I'm bigger, I'm better, I'm a strong, independent woman. Ah! Oh! You're not laughing at me, are you? Oh, thank you for finding me again, Derek.
I love you, Lena.
I love you, Derek. And I suppose I always have.
You are my princess.
That's what you call me too, Mum. When he raped me,
I don't know why she's saying this.
He plays music every time. He put it on full blast, and that's when I knew I was in for it. You'd take Kathleen out to help you shop for the Sunday roast, and Myra had already left home by then. So I got left on my own with him. And he plays music so loud. So when you came back, you always turned it down. I'm from upstairs, in my room. He knew he got to stop, Mum.
She's lying.
I never thought I'd be able to tell him, Mum.
Reedy!
Leave her!
We're getting married, and all the bad times can finally be wiped away. This is my chance to heal all the painful memories.
Your painful memories?
He was violent, but he's a changed man. And he never laid a finger on you.
He was a genius at hiding it.
Really, stop it. I won't have it.
He always had stubble. I always had a rash, spots on my face.
All teenagers get spots.
Every time he said I was asking for it.
Rainey, I want you to tell me the absolute truth and look me in the eye. You can have your big day with Derek. I won't spoil a thing. But as soon as Pete comes back, we'll leave it. I've told you. I always knew it'd kill me. And kill you to find out. But I didn't think it'd hurt this much. My own mum not believing me. I can read my daughters like books. And if it was happening to you, what about Kathleen? Maybe she was a bit old. We were all so close. We had no secrets.
There's always secrets, Mum.
And you were a little horror. You made everybody's lives difficult. You were never a victim.
Why do you think I was so bad?
Rainey, tell me this is one of your games.
Sorry.
But I would have known.
How can you ever know? Unless it's happened to you. You keep it to yourself. You hide it. Because it's shameful and it's dirty. And all the time, I was saying no one's going to believe me. And he was right. Because you still don't.
Oh, really?
Now do you know why I wanted him gone for good? Do you? One way.
Oh, my little girl. Come on.
Hey, you know, you could actually live in a school. The caretaker's office is like a survival supermarket. Oh,
thank you.
So, how was your mate Tennyson coming on in, eh? Yeah.
Oh. Yo! Right, your turn.
What?
Hey!
Concentrate on your work, Mrs.
Oh, you're about influence.
I can't help it. I always had the best time when I'm with you. You're the only person that really allows me to be myself, you know? How long you got to go?
I'm just finishing up the conclusion now.
All right. Get on with it. Ignore me. Come on.
Him back in the house. Feels like I'm helpless and 13 all over again.
13?
Hating my own body. I'm feeling different from all the other girls at school. I'm trapped in my own head. You know, the first time.
You don't have to tell me.
He said that if I told anyone, that he'd kick us out and we'd be homeless. I started to kick off to make things harder for him at home.
You weren't always trouble. You were kind and well-behaved. And you changed. I just saw it was your hormones.
All the drinking and drugs, getting in trouble with the police, lads, it was all just to block him out.
Why didn't I see
it? We used to pray every night that you'd find out. Yeah, just after my 15th birthday, I dug my nails in his arms and he drew blood. And he said that the dog had attacked him. Mum, that was the day that he broke your jaw. He said it was to teach you a lesson. So I just had to keep on letting him. Then he tried to make it up to you, do you remember? He paid for you and your mates to go on holiday to Margate and Kathleen had got a new job working away. I had a whole week on my own with him.
When I came back, you wouldn't talk to me. I thought you were just jealous because I'd had a holiday. Then you really went off the rails, hanging out with that smackhead Mickey from the estate. Shoplifting.
No, because I wanted to get done. I wanted to get taken away.
I couldn't handle you. I was so horrible to you.
Can't blame yourself, Mum.
I could have stopped it. It was a cry for help.
You didn't know.
But the time she begged me to leave him, and I threw you out. And that little street rat Mickey getting you pregnant, and you goaded me with it. But you had no self-respect. And I caused that.
No, Derek caused that.
I'm to blame. I've been a terrible, neglectful mother. And when you were at your most vulnerable, I sent you away to give your baby up.
You know, out of all the McQueens, I thought you were different. I suppose we're all selfish.
Yeah.
I mean, look at Mum. She'd pick Pete any day over me.
It's because she's a screw-up.
She makes me feel so worthless. I remember the first time I begged her to leave Pete. And she was so drunk, she said she wished she got rid of me.
She didn't mean that.
Oh, she did. At the time, she did. Why is she like this? What have I done?
Nothing. Nothing. You've done nothing. I mean, she's an addict. And I know how hard that is. I've lived with one.
But she isn't like this with Cleo and Celine. Why does she love me?
I'm sure she does. Look, I know that you can't forgive me, and I totally get that, but please know that I love you, and I will spend the rest of my life reminding you of that. Dance.
No.
Yep.
Absolutely not.
Okay. We're kids. We're in your bedroom, yeah? We've got deodorant cans as microphones. Hey? Come on! You can't make me do this on my own. Yes.
There were 10 other teenage girls in that refuge waiting to have the babies.
It was a charity. I thought they'd look after you.
Oh, they tried the best, but we were sleeping in the same room as the other mums trying to look after the kids, so I was so young. It was a hellhole.
Derek made me say he'd gone to stay with an auntie. He didn't want a screaming baby in the house. He didn't want another mouth to feed. I didn't think you were capable of being a mum. You were feral.
You know, when I was in labour, all I wanted was you.
I'm so sorry.
And after I gave birth, she was this little ball of angry crying. She was so beautiful. And held her for a minute. They were keen to whisk her away to her adopted parents. And then when I had to face them, ready to sign her over, I know I'd agreed to it.
And that is why you will always be a better mum than Myra. Because you turned up back on our doorstep with Portia in your arms. And you said, I don't care what they think.
Because I'm keeping her. It's the best thing I ever did. I just wish I could tell her that.
Oh, it's about time you did, love.
No.
But it would fix so many things between you both.
No, I can't.
Well, I don't care if it puts me in a bad light anymore. You don't have to protect me.
No, I'm protecting Portia.
Why? She needs to know how you fought for her, how loved she was.
No, because Mickey from the estate.
She knows her dad was a wrong'un.
No, she doesn't. Because Mickey from the estate was a saint compared to a real dad. I before she was born. 9 months after Margate.
What have I done to you and Portia? I chose to stay with him for all those years. Oh, sweetheart.
Mom, the guilt's got to stop for both of us. There's only one person who's caused this.
Malena! Malena!
And he sat on my sofa, feet under the table again, knowing what he's done to you.
What he did to you too, Mom.
Well, he's not getting away with it. Not for 1 second more.
There. Finished.
Great.
You're my hero. You can go now.
It's not why you brought me here, is it?
Okay. You think I'm here for one thing? It's just in a moment. Grab your stuff.
I didn't mean to upset you.
Cleo, love, I've got work in the morning. I'm worried about your mum. I need to go and see her.
Pete.
She'll still be up getting wasted. I need to put her to bed. Take care of her.
I'm sorry.
I only came back to Winnie last time because you asked me to. Maybe I should just go again.
No, don't. Stay here a while.
You won't know what you really are. And you are going to admit what you did to my daughter.
You say out loud what you really are.
The absolute least you can do. Derek!
You are not gonna die before you say sorry to me.
Ambulance!
The sooner it happens. We've got a big loving family, and he can't take that away from us. Let this be an end to it.
Supports information for the issues raised can be found online. Channel4.com/support is where it's always at. 10 o'clock tonight on 4 Men and Their Ponies, an obsession. A bit weird, a lot weird. Channel 4 News comes next.
Despite everything that's happened, I mean, I am still your favourite cousin, aren't I?
Yeah? Of course you are. And you are completely forgiven.
Yes!